not happening. Some places you may hear them called bunny boots, different boots like that, and that's what they're basically doing. Sometimes you may not have boots. What we're going to do is what's called float the heels. I know you've already seen a picture of that. Person laying on their back on their side, it's where there's a pillow underneath right by the ankle, and the heels are floated. They're not in contact with the bed.
Does this normally happen to bedridden people?
Yeah, most of the time. Cold and warm applications. Now, while you may not be putting them on, because the CMA or the licensed nurse is mostly going to do the cold and hot applications, I want you to know about them. Of course, we know heat can burn and damage tissue. That's why actually every 20 minutes, if somebody has a heat application on, somebody needs to take it off and visually look at the skin and make sure it's not being burned. Cold can also cause tissue damage just as much. So if they have cold on, if they have hot on, basically we have to be checking the skin. Somebody does every 20 minutes.
Does it have to step for a certain amount of time?
Just basically to visually look at all the skin and make sure.
But they don't put it directly on, do they?
They always have something
under it,
right? Like it's it depends. Like, now, most of the time, what we do for heat applications is, and basically it kind of shows you here in, I think, one of these pictures, because we don't have all this super equipment in the nursing homes, so we have to improvise. A lot of times what we'll do, like if we're putting a heat application on somebody, we'll get a hot towel, wrap it around them, get a trash bag like that, wrap it around to basically insulate it, and then a towel to catch any of the drips. So in that case, yeah, it rides right up against them. Now the ice packs, ice, when we apply ice, we're going to put in a baggie or a glove, and that we are going to wrap in like a washcloth or a hand towel, you know. But the thing is, temperature of the water is 105.
Do they ever use like hot and cold ointments, you know, like ice and hot and stuff like that?
Sometimes they do. A lot of times with our folks, though, because the skin is so dry and so fragile, it does tend to burn them.
Or ear.
Mm-hmm. Now, the picture here on page 332 is an Aqua K pad. What that does is the temperature of the water can be set, 103, 104, whatever, and that box will heat up the water. Those cords that go out from it, what it'll do is it'll circulate blood. It'll circulate water out to like this green pad that you see in the bottom of the picture. It'll circulate it out to that pad. The warm water will circulate around the pad, and then through the other side of the hose, the water will come back in and be reheated. So it's a circuit of water going out that's warm, coming back that's cool to get rewarmed. So while the water is basically in this pad, it's providing a continuous heat to like an arm or a leg or something like that, because you can imagine if we're using the washcloths, you know, we've got to be going back constantly and reheating them. Well, this will be constant heat, okay, about whatever it's set at. But of course, the thing is, we do have to, like I said, virtually check the skin every 20 minutes. Here it shows you the ice pack. It's usually the ice basically in a baggie like that, or we put it in a glove, we wrap it around. Now there is something called a polar pack. It's something very similar to the Aqua K, but instead of circulating hot water, polar, of course, makes sense, it's going to circulate cold water. That is used a lot for like people that get joint replacements, shoulder, knee, you know, because you put the cold pack on them and it just feels good. It decreases swelling, and a lot of people, not everybody, but a lot of people virtually get relief from it, stuff like that. So Okay, let me finalize this thing here and stop it. Okay, let me finalize this thing here and stop it.